We were just starting to come right as far as the business goes. And it started to sink in that it was a bit like a war zone, to be honest. There was houses going down the river, there was caravans, there was cars. To me, it looked like there'd been a tsunami had gone through there. That's what you would expect, except it would come from up there and not out there.
With each passing day, we start to understand the real-life scale of Cyclone Gabrielle. Today, we're down here in the Hawke's Bay in Esk Valley, which is one of the hardest hit places locally. We're going to be talking with an amazing woman who runs a hotel and camping ground here in the valley, and she's been bringing in supplies and donations from the entire community and the entire country.
My name's Adrienne Morrin, and I'm, along with my husband Trevor, we're the publicans of the Bayview Hotel. On Tuesday morning, we were asked by the police, when it became apparent the scale of what was happening on the other side of the hill, to be an evacuation point. And as the day went on, any medical attention. So that was our first focus, the evacuees. And then it's now turned into a place where people come and donate. It's the same scale of boom. When the Prime Minister decided that she was going to shut down the country, going to whichever level we went to, that has the same effect on a business. You lose your income straight away. This did the same thing when the power went off. When it first was apparent what had happened, my son's a volunteer firefighter, and I knew that, you know, things had gone really bad over the other side. And it was just the initial chaos. I think the thing that seemed to take most people by surprise was the fact we lost cell phone coverage, which made that initial rescue operation really difficult. There was some outstanding people down there who worked around that, in particular Coast Guard. And then at that point, they were still dealing with the fact that the fire station could probably get flooded. So it was a pretty touch and go situation for a while that they would have to shift that command centre. So it was just all that chaos. I was really surprised by that. To be honest, we've only really started to see what's on the TV. So, because we've only just got the power back to be able to do that. So it's hard to know what was reported.
If, you know, anybody talks about the slash, I'd say that's got quite a bit to do with it. Where they've been logging, that's trees that they've left behind. When it rains hard like that in the hills, that gets washed down here, and I believe that's what's done a lot of the destruction. Builds up, and then that seems to be what breaks the bridges. And there's been quite a lot of talk about it for a long time, I think, because the cyclone hail, all that slash came down into Gisborne, and that created a bit of damage. So it's not a new subject, and it's probably not something that's going to be increasingly monitored. Still a lot of uncertainty, I think. And I understand it takes a while for the government and the council to get things where they are. I think people just need that surety, as if I need some money, this is where I can go. If I need some housing, this is where I can go. And what their future's going to look like.
You can stay up to date with all of our news at operationpeople.com, and you can sign up to our mailing list to be the first to know what's really going on here down in Napier.